While we reach the end of this year, I have decided to summarize what has happened in the biggest sporting event of 2018, the FIFA World Cup. This map represents teams and the highest round that they have qualified. For instance, France and Croatia faced off in the final, Belgium and England reached the semi-final, and so on. During the 2018 World Cup tournament, in sum, 169 goals were scored in 64 matches. The first pie chart at the top left describes the percentages of goals were scored in each half and extra time. Around 39% of the goals were scored in the first half, compared with 60% in the second half. The second pie chart, as well as the contingency table, displays the number and percent of the various type of goals during the matches. About 19% of the goals scored were header goals, 4% free kicks, 13% kicks from the penalty mark, 7% own goals, and around 57% didn't belong to any of these classes. Moreover, 22 goals were scored following a corner, and most of them were delivered through a header. The statistic at the bottom left shows the composition of goals in each half and extra time. The right histogram represents the goal distribution. In 10-minute intervals, the more goals were scored between 50th and 60th minutes. However, in 5-minute intervals, the more goals were scored in the 90 to 95-minute bin. I surmise that there would be fewer goals in the first 5 minutes of the games, but results suggest that fewer goals were scored in the 25 to 30-minute time range. As the bar chart depicts, Belgium, France, Croatia, and England are the top three on the list of goals scored. A closer look at the how goals were scored discloses that England scored 12 goals, 5 of them were scored through the header. That means England made the most headed goals at the 2018 World Cup. France scored 14 goals, which 2 of them were own goals. Australia and Iran did earn goals only by penalty kicks or own goals. The top right graph shows teams that put the ball into their own nets. Among these teams, Russia has actually scored 2 own goals. The bottom right bubble graph depicts teams which were awarded penalties during the match. Among teams that scored the penalty kicks, England and France have scored 3 goals. As you can see, 7 teams failed their penalties. The map illustrates the average of passing accuracy and ball possession rate, also on average for teams. Passing accuracy percentage varies between 68% to 91%. Spain, Germany, and Brazil have the best average of passing accuracy. The average of correct passes for France is around 82%. Iran has the worst passing accuracy. Technically speaking, the number of passes the team has completed is likely occurred by chance. After Iran, Iceland and Sweden have the lowest rates of accurate passes. It seems that teams' passing performance has affected their ball possession. In general, ball possession rate changes between 34% to 68%. Examining the ball possession rate of teams reveals that the highest rates belong to Spain, Germany, and Argentina. On the contrary, Iran, Iceland, and Russia have the lowest percentages of ball possession. Next map portrays the average number of fouls for each team. The average number of fouls for South Korea, Morocco, and Russia is 21, 20, and 19 fouls more than any other teams. In contrast, Spain, Japan, and Germany have the lowest average number of fouls have committed. France, on average, has committed about 13 fouls per game during this tournament. Now, in regard to this map and previous map, the question arose whether it is possible to classify teams based on the percentage of ball possession and the number of fouls they have committed. Visually, you can see there are two clusters. As box plot shows, the first cluster has a higher median ball possession percentage and a lower median number of fouls than the second cluster. The left scatter plot compares the match outcomes between two clusters. The number of teams winning in the first cluster are remarkably higher than the second cluster. On the other hand, there are more losing teams in the second cluster. The right plot compares the number of goals per game between the two clusters, and the number of goals were scored is notably higher in the first cluster. In sum, I want to point out that the higher ball possession and the lower fouls committed won't guarantee to win, but it sounds that they enhance chances of success. The bar graph looks at the average number of shots and shots on goal per team. As we can see, Germany with about 22, Brazil 21, and Spain 17 shots stand out in the top positions. France on average had 12 shots per game. On the right end, we can find Iran with 7, Panama approximately 8, and Russia 9 shots. In regard to shots on goal, Brazil with about 8, Germany 7 and Belgium 6 shots have the highest average number of shots on goal, and Iran with 1, Egypt and Serbia each with about 2 have the lowest average number of shots on goal. On average, France had around 4 shots on goal during 7 matches. Do more shots and shots on goal mean more success for a team? The scatter plot illustrates the number of shots versus the number of shots on goal per match. The plot is color-coded by the match outcome. The losing teams had a lower number of shots and shots on goal compared to drawing and winning teams. However, it seems that the total number of shots on goal is more important than the total number of shots. The gist of the story is that the teams who had more ratio of shots on goal show an increased probability of winning compared to teams who just had more shots. Moving on to the system of play, we can see all played formations. The last three formations were only played in one game. The 4-3-2-1, commonly described as the Christmas tree formation, was used by Croatia. The 4-3-1-2 was used by Colombia. And the 3-4-3, a highly offensive formation, was used by Poland. The 3-5-2 system was played in two games exclusively by Nigeria national team. The 4-1-2-1-2 or 4-4-2 diamond formation adopted three times by Uruguay. This tactic obviously has the highest average of victory. The modern 4-2-3-1 defensive formation is widely utilized during the 2018 World Cup. In comparison with the traditional 4-4-2 formation, it has a lesser victory average and a greater loss average. France mainly used 4-2-3-1 formation. However, at the World Cup final, France played in the 4-4-2 formation. Regarding the average number of goals, the 3-1-4-2 formation is a better option for goal scoring. It's noteworthy to mention that this formation chiefly played by England during the 2018 World Cup. I have classified teams based on their average number of tackles. The range of tackles in the first group is around 11 for Uruguay to 15 for Colombia, with a median of 13. In the second group, the median of the distribution of tackles is about 9, which lies within the range of values between 8.5 for Mexico and 11 for Argentina. France also has classified in this group with an average of 8.5 tackles per game. The third group has the lowest average number of tackles. And Australia, with an average of 4, has done the least number of tackles. Costa Rica, with an average of 7 tackles per game, is located at the top of the third group. It is noticeable that the median of tackles in the third group is approximately half of the median of tackles in the first group. Yellow bar graph displays the average number of yellow cards were issued for each team. Panama, South Korea, and Serbia on average received a higher number of yellow cards. You are able to pinpoint France in the middle of the graph with an average of 1.7 cards. As shown in the bubble graph, during the 2018 World Cup, Colombia, Germany, Russia, and Switzerland are the teams which earned red cards. Now let's take a look at other teams' features. The first graph shows the average number of corner kicks for the teams. Brazil, Germany, and Switzerland have the highest number of corner kicks. On the other hand, Iran, Panama, and Egypt have the lowest average number of kicks. France, the champion of the 2018 World Cup, on average executed 3 corners per match. Just 22 out of 604 corner kicks, or 3.6% of the corners, ended in the goal. As the bar chart indicates, teams performed more corner kicks when winning. The second graph represents which teams, on average, have been caught offside the most per game. Senegal, Peru, Panama, and Germany are at the top of the list. South Korea was never caught in an offside position during the 2018 World Cup. In addition, Iceland and Uruguay have been caught less than any other teams. France has been flagged offside on average 5 times per match. In general, teams lost their games have a higher average of offside calls. With respect to the average number of injuries, as shown in the last graph, Tunisia with about 4, Iran 3, and South Korea 2 injuries have the highest average injury rates. France on average had 1 injury per match. A number of teams include Spain, Portugal, Japan, Uruguay, Germany, Australia, and Argentina on average had less than 5 injuries per match. Finally, it's time to consider referees. As we can see, 28 referees were chosen from 27 countries. The United States didn't have a team at the 2018 World Cup, but it had 2 referees, one from New Jersey and the other from Texas. The size of the points indicates the number of games for each referee. Nestor Pitana from Argentina officiated 5 games more than any other referees. In the second place, Alireza Fahani from Iran and Bjorn Kuipers from the Netherlands each refereed 4 games. The color of the points shows the average number of cards have been issued by each referee. Rafshan Irmatov from Uzbekistan awarded 13 yellow cards just in 2 games. Next, there is Sergei Karasev from Russia, which gave 6 cards in 1 match. Matthew Conger, a New Zealand football referee, and Yair Murafo from the United States each have taken charge of 1 game and shown 1 yellow card. Interestingly, these 2 happy guys both were born in Texas. In summary, France followed moderation in all things and won the 2018 World Cup. By the way, I have gleaned the data from ESPN and Fox Sports websites. I'm Mohammad Sahib Honar, and thank you for watching this video.